Japan ends its blanket COVID testing of visitors from China. Japan had imposed stricter arrival protocols on Chinese travelers as the mainland dealt with a surge in cases last December. But Tokyo said beginning Wednesday, only passengers on select flights will be subject to testing. Travelers, though, will still have to show a negative test result taken 72 hours before departure. At least 32 are dead and 85 injured in the deadliest rail crash in Greece in decades. A passenger train was traveling from Athens to the northern city of Thessaloniki when it collided at high speed with a cargo train outside the city of Larissa. The impact caused a fire in the number of carriages, burning many commuters who were rushed to hospitals. Local media reported about 350 people were traveling on the passenger train. Police are still investigating the cause of the incident. Greece's aging railway system is in need of modernizing, with many trains traveling on single tracks and signaling and automatic control systems yet to be installed in many areas. Russian President Vladimir Putin orders a tightening of border controls after a flurry of drone attacks targeted regions inside Russia. Most of the drones hit areas near the border with Ukraine, while one hit deep inside the country, less than 100 kilometers from Moscow. It's suspected to have targeted but did not hit a Gazprom gas distribution facility. No casualties have been reported. Ukraine authorities have not taken responsibility for the strikes, but have claimed the right to such forays to turn back Russia's invasion. Also on Tuesday, the hacking of Russian TV channels and radio stations, as well as the temporary closure of St. Petersburg's airport, fed suspicion that Kyiv could be behind the disruptions. Three people linked to a shipwreck that left dozens of migrants dead have been arrested in Italy. Local police say the three individuals, a Turkish man and two Pakistani nationals, have been detained on suspicion of human smuggling. Officials add a manhunt is now underway for a fourth suspect. The vessel was reportedly carrying about 200 people from Middle Eastern countries when it broke apart on rocks off the coast of Italy's Calabria region. So far, 64 have been confirmed killed. Officials warn the death toll could climb to more than 100. Philippine President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. sees no need for additional powers to curb inflation. Marcos said that proposal of House lawmaker Stella Kimbo is not necessary.
We declare, for example, if we declare an emergency, I have already the power to declare an emergency and to control the prices of commodities. So that I don't think there is any need for more than that. That is sufficient.
Kimbo earlier said additional powers for Marcos will help stabilize food prices and fight hoarding and price manipulation. But Marcos says, as Agriculture Secretary, there are some factors that he can't control.
Noong February, hindi pa bumababa masyadong fuel prices at ngayon pa lang natin inaayos yung food supply para yung inflation na galing sa agricultural products ay mabawasan. Wala tayong magagawa sa fuel, wala tayong magagawa doon sa mga iba't ibang inputs. The other elements of inflation hindi natin masyadong makontrol.